They're loud, they're annoying, they're ugly. And no, they're not back. But one local professor has dug up something pretty incredible. We're finding out that cicadas even bothered the dinosaurs.
Yeah, years, many, many years ago. Valeria Beatty has much more on the ancient insect invasion.
They're creepy, they're loud, and now prehistoric. We're talking about cicadas. And scientists are realizing that they're now older than they once thought.
It came out of the tree, it hatched right away and fell into the sap and died.
That's it. That's the entire life story of one little cicada. But this particular cicada, only about 2 to 3 millimeters in size, is changing what scientists know about the little buggers. Just how old is it?
Between 97 and 110 million years old.
How do you know that?
The rock in which the amber was mined from has been radiometrically dated.
This was the time of the Cretaceous period, when there was one big landmass called Pangaea, and horned dinosaurs, even T-Rex and Triceratops, roamed the Earth.
Now, just seeing this sort of scene with dinosaurs walking through like you saw in Jurassic Park, the trees have to be screaming of cicadas as well.
Dr. Kritsky says realizing cicadas are this old...
Because they're clearly cicadas, it means that the cicadas as a group are a much more ancient group than we expected.
But the bigger surprise is the evolution of the cicada.
What was a real surprise to us was that the parts of the cicada foreleg, which is what they used to dig, has changed very little in the last 110 million years. And that's what was kind of neat.
The next time we'll be able to catch these dinosaur-bothering bugs, 2017.
So when the cicadas come back, we'll think Jurassic Park.
You will actually more Cretaceous Park.
Oh, Cretaceous Park.
Next for Dr. Kritsky, in 2014, he's going to be studying Brown and Claremont County. He's going to watch to see if there's a missed population of cicadas that actually emerges. Valeria Beatty, News 5.